Although Pug makes writing HTML quicker, so far none of what we've seen is particularly sophisticated. We're still basically writing static, unchanging HTML files. Quickly and in a more efficient way than before by using include and extends, but still static HTML. But Pug is much cleverer than that. It supports JavaScript, all its features like variables, loops, and conditions, and it's thus a fully fledged programming language in its own right. Let's take a look at how this works. For this lesson, let's have a break from Acme Cleaning Services and create a new Lesson 08 directory, and in it a new file, which we'll name variables.pug. To set a new variable in JavaScript, we use let or const, variable name equals value. In Pug, we have to prefix that with a dash and a space, so it's dash space let variable name equals value. Make a new variable, first name, and set its value to your name. At this stage, this is called unbuffered code. We've assigned a value to a variable, and that variable is now available to be used, but we haven't output anything to the browser yet. Then there are several ways to display the value of the variable in the browser. We can use interpolation, a hash followed by curly braces enclosing the variable name. Hash curly braces first name returns Richard. Except that there's a problem with that. Pug thinks, because it's the first word on the line, that it should return HTML elements called Richard, which isn't what we want. We need to have another go. P, hash curly braces first name, returns an HTML paragraph with the content Richard. That's much more useful. And we can create any other HTML elements with variable values in them in this way. P.firstname, hash curly braces first name gives us a paragraph with the class name first name with the contents Richard. Hash first name, hash curly braces first name gives us a div with the ID name first name and the contents Richard. A second way to return the value of a variable is to use an HTML element followed immediately by an equals sign, then a space, and then the plain variable name. P equals first name gives us Richard inside P tags. It's vital that there's no space between the HTML tag and the equals sign, or it won't work. The fact that we've used the equals sign means that Pug is expecting a variable to follow. So p.firstname equals firstname gives us a paragraph with the class name firstname and the contents Richard. Hash.firstname equals firstname gives us a div with firstname as the ID name. This is called buffered code. This is when the variable value is evaluated and sent to output. Let's set another variable, last name. Dash let last name equals Stibbard. To display the two names with a space between them, we can use JavaScript concatenation with plus signs. And we can use the same technique to join strings and variable values. That does the trick, it displays what we want, but this can become a bit clunky, so an alternative is to use an object literal. And we can add in other text with this. Which is a bit easier on the eye. You can, of course, set another variable using any of these techniques and return that in the browser. So dash let full name equals. And then use an object literal to return both of those names together as the new variable full name. And then p hash full name equals the variable full name. That's an overview of setting and returning variables in Pug. In the next lesson, we'll build on this by working with arrays and objects and looping through these to return multiple values.